Welcome students, welcome in our e-learning classes of Bardhaman Model School. Student, today I will discuss the structure of I, that is in class 8 syllabus. So previously I have discussed, but today I will just one picture I have taken here, and I will show you the every parts which are in our syllabus, and I will discuss. First of all, and we know that the I, the human eye, is the most beautiful organ in our body. Okay, so some parts are to be discussed here. First of all, that is cornea. What is cornea? Just wait, students, I will show you. That is okay, here that part, that outermost part, that part is called cornea. That part is called cornea. Okay, first of all, what is cornea? Cornea is the that in the in the diagram, that portion, okay, that is called cornea. Okay, first of all, cornea is the outermost part of our eye. It is made of by transparent substance. Light enters into through the cornea, and the main function of that cornea is to protect our eye, and it also help to focus the light, as it has the converging nature. That's the main function of cornea. That main as it is the outermost part, protect the inner part of eye, and it helps to focus the light. Next part, that is iris. So outermost part, that is cornea, and just before that, behind that that cornea part, okay, sorry, that is iris part. Okay, in the and actually iris is the colorful part of our eye, and it gives the distinctive color of human eye. And in the middle of the iris there is a hole. That portion is known as pupil. Okay, so in the middle of iris there is a hole, that is called pupil. The size of the pupil can vary. It means, and that variation is done by the iris. Okay, so controlling the size of pupil is the function of iris, and it appears black because no light is reflected from there. That's why it appears black. And one thing, students, you can notice that the various size of pupil, just torch this focus a light on your friend's eye, and that you will see that the pupil is decreased, and removing the torch light, the pupil is automatically increased. So that increase and decrease of it means the size of the pupil is increased or decreased, and that is controlled by the iris. Okay, that is the main function of iris. Next, just behind the pupil, that is eye lens. It is the eye lens. It is made of a transparent and flexible substance. Eye lens is held in its position by the help of the ciliary muscle. It is in its position with the help of ciliary muscle. Okay. Next, the part which is in your syllabus, that is retina. Okay. At the back of the eye, that is the retina. Retina means where the image is formed. In the retina, so many photoeffective cells are there, like rod cell, cone cell. Rod cells is very much effective in dim light, and cone cells is very much effective in bright light. And one thing, students, you have to know that is that identification of color is done by the cone cells. Identification, that is green, it is green, red, blue, that is done by the cone cells. Okay. And next part, so mainly the function of retina, it's like a screen. Okay, image is formed here. Okay, image is formed here. Next part, that is optical nerves. So that portion, optical nerves. What is the function of optical nerves? That electric signal, which which is formed at the that image, which is formed at the retina, that image transferred into electric electric signal transferred to the brain. That is the function of optical nerve. And one thing, students, at that point no photo effective cells are there, or photo sensitive cells is not there. It means, so any image is not formed here. That's why this spot is called blind spot. Okay, that spot is called blind spot. And between cornea and eye lens, a fluid is there that is called aqueous humor. And lens and retina, there is a liquid, its name is vitreous humor. Okay, so these parts are in your syllabus. I have discussed here. And one thing, students, that the disease myopia, hypermetropia, metropia, cataract, presbyopia. In myopia, you can see I change the focus of the camera. In myopia, people can see the nearby object, cannot see the far object. In hypermetropia, people can see the far object but cannot see the nearby object. Cataracts is means that cloudy vision of the eye. Mainly is that happens only for the aged person. There is a cloud covered in front of lens. That's why it creates a blurred vision, and it is easily recovered by the surgery. And presbyopia. Presbyopia means that it cannot fix the power of accommodation. Power of accommodation, we will discuss it later. Okay, it is in this disease, people cannot see the nearby object properly, just as hypermetropia. Okay, and for myopia, correction of myopia by convex lens, correction of hypermetropia by concave lens, and presbyopia, that is bifocal lens. Okay. So these are the, and what is the far point of eye? Far point of eye infinity, and in near point of eye, that is 25 centimeter. Okay. So students, today I have discussed the eye portion of your syllabus. Next day, I will start another chapter. Thank you, students. Bye.